beloved disciple, beloved, loved by Jesus, loved by the one who was in the beginning with God, loved by the one who is greater than all of us and yet washes our feet, setting the example of humility and servitude. You might think that Jesus, that because Jesus calls me his beloved disciple, that I have reason to be proud. Oh, how I have learned that the opposite is true. I once thought that I might hold a place of power and prestige in his kingdom, but he has shown me over and over that the war he wages is a spiritual battle. He reaches out to the needy, to paupers. He does not seek out the rich and powerful. He dines in the homes of sinners and common folk, not the rich and elite. I have seen him equally befriend a well-known Pharisee and an immoral woman, forgiving both. God has sent his son because he loved the world, the lowly, me, so much. So much that he does not want any one of us to perish, but to have everlasting life. This Jesus, he is the way, the truth. He is life. Even though we are his closest friends and followers, I don't think we truly understand the depth of his love. I believe he would give his life for mine. How could I not do the same? Will my pride cause me to stumble? Will I betray him? Could I? Is it I?
I have been listening to Jesus speak tonight around this table, and I simply do not understand. Words meant to comfort, but words met with confusion and misunderstanding. Talk of betrayal met with incredulity and suspicion. Where is he going? There is so much yet to be done. Right here, right now. Sometimes I marvel that I, Thomas, have seen him with my own eyes, have touched my Lord and my Master with my own hands. I have watched him perform wonders and change lives. I don't want him to go away. Not now, not ever. And how can we follow him if we don't know where he is going? Is there something I haven't done or will do that will contribute to this betrayal he speaks of? Has he seen my lack of faith, my hidden doubts, my fear? Is it I?
I am Judas Iscariot, the treasurer for this group. I have followed Jesus, but I am growing tired of his reluctance to stand against our oppressors. I believe he is who he says he is, but why would God send a Messiah for this? To wash feet and serve bread. I have no need of a spiritual king. We need a political king, someone to rise up and overthrow these Roman tyrants. Thousands of people follow him over mountainsides and across rivers to hear him speak. Surely he could put together an army in no time. Something must be done to force him to make his move to lead us to victory, to establish a new kingdom. A betrayer among us indeed. All these men look at one another suspiciously around this table, wondering, guessing, accusing. They look inwardly and ponder their own motivations. Why do they sit here like sheep waiting for a shepherd? Someone must do something. Well, I have. Tonight, with the elders and chief priests, will help me help him usher in the promised kingdom. History will thank me for this. Oh yes, someone has betrayed him. Perhaps all of us will do so before this night is over. Master, is it I?